Synapse Pain and Spine Clinic in Chennai, India. I'm an interventional spine and pain physician. I also do a significant amount of radio frequency ablation treatments for trigeminal neuralgia. Today, I'm going to explain to you what, as a patient, you should expect when you are planned or scheduled for trigeminal neuralgia radio frequency ablation. Now, trigeminal neuralgia is a very painful facial pain condition. So usually the diagnosis is confirmed. So usually the pain may be along the first, second or the third nerves. Sometimes we may call them as V1, V2 or V3. V stands for the fifth nerve, which is the trigeminal nerve. So the pain can be along V1, V2 or V3 for the trigeminal neuralgia. First, I would like to assess you in terms of where the pain is. Next, I would like to get your MRI. So in the MRI, I am looking to see if, as the trigeminal nerve comes out of the brain, there is a blood vessel sometimes that touches the nerve, which causes irritation of the trigeminal nerve. This can make it very bad. So usually I prescribe medicines which are nerve medicines for trigeminal neuralgia. If patients are happy with nerve medicines, I may increase or decrease the dose and make sure you are comfortable with medication. There are a group of patients who are elderly. So a lot of times I see trigeminal patients in the 50, 60, 70, 80 age group. This group of patients are not good candidates for trigeminal brain surgery. So in this group of patients where they are not happy with medication, I may recommend radio frequency ablation. Radio frequency ablation is an injection procedure which is a safe and effective treatment for treating trigeminal neuralgia. So usually if I am planning the procedure in the morning, I make sure you have to come to the clinic without eating your breakfast. After you come to the clinic, I may take you to the procedure room. After making sure we change your clothes and get your consent, I would like to insert a normal IV line. Through that, I may give you some sedation. So the sedation is to make sure you're comfortable during the procedure. We'll shift you to a procedure room or an operating theater. In the operating theater, I will also make sure I give you good local anesthesia where I'm going to do the procedure, making sure you're absolutely comfortable during the procedure. This procedure is image guided or x-ray guided. So you'll be lying down on the table. The x-ray machine will be around you, but it will not be touching you. During the procedure, I will make sure you have your ECG, your blood pressure, your pulse being monitored continuously by my anesthesiology colleagues who are standing by, making sure you're comfortable and also you're safe during the procedure. Typically, it takes me about 15 to 20 minutes for doing the radio frequency ablation of the trigeminal ganglion. Probably I must have done somewhere between 4,000 to 5,000 trigeminal radio frequency ablations. So I'm proud to say, probably in this part of the world at least, I must have done the maximum trigeminal RF ablations. After I identify the trigeminal foramen ovale, which is the structure in the brain, I give good local anesthesia, insert the radio frequency needle carefully under x-ray guidance, and once I get the trigeminal ganglion, I will make sure you're comfortable and then do the radio frequency ablation itself. So typically, this procedure in my hands takes about 15 minutes. I've not had any comorbidities or any complications with trigeminal neuralgia so far. So they are absolutely safe and very effective procedures, which cause dramatic relief of the original pain. So most of my patients have anywhere between 80 to 100% pain relief after the procedure. And after the procedure, I'm able to drastically reduce the previous medication that they were taking. So after the procedure is over, the patient is wheeled out into the recovery room where they are monitored and kept under observation for a period of about 2 hours. So they are absolutely comfortable. And then after 2 hours, we discharge these patients. So usually the hospital stay is anywhere around 4 hours. So we encourage them to take rest that day. The next day onwards, you are good to do your normal activities or go back to work. So essentially, it is a safe and very effective procedure which is done on a daycare basis with x-ray guidance under local anesthesia or sedation. So after the procedure, I may review you after a couple of days, and then gradually I start reducing the previous medication, and you can expect good pain relief somewhere around 90 to 100%, and we gradually reduce the medication and keep checking on you periodically. So I would like to stress that trigeminal neuralgia is a very, very painful facial pain condition. and the radio frequency ablation is the standard of care throughout the world, especially suitable for patients who don't get adequate pain relief with medicines like Tegretol, Oxetol, and Baclofen. So this group of medicines, these patients who are not happy and who are in the elderly population. So when I say elderly, patients in the 60, 70, 80 age group, radio frequency ablation of regional ganglion is the procedure of choice. It can be done very safely and effectively, and the pain can be completely abolished. If you have more questions on regional neuralgia, you can contact the phone number given below or put your queries in the comment section. I'll be happy to answer them. So this is Dr. Karthik Natarajan from Chennai, India, talking about trigeminal ganglion, radio frequency, or RF ablation. Thank you.